Albert, thank you for meeting with us today to talk about your experience with the Cross-Cultural Leadership Internship Program during the summer of 2009. We have a series of questions. We'll start off with your name, your major, your hometown, and what year are you graduating?
Well, I'm Albert Toscano. I'm an accounting major, sophomore right now, and I will graduate in 2012.
Tell us about your placement and what you did there.
I worked for the Los Angeles Urban League in Crenshaw, California, well, just a suburb of LA, and I worked in the marketing department, but I actually got to work in all aspects of the company.
That's good. Tell us a story about a good experience that you had at your placement.
I think it was my last weekend there, and there's planning for a big marketing campaign to push the Head Start, the preschool program. And the last weekend there, I actually got to work with the preschool kids. And they had a big carnival for them, and it was a big recruitment process. But you just got to see, you know, all the work that you had done in the past 7 weeks pay off, finally. And you got to interact and play games with them and help them out. And I think it was just a real humbling experience to know that all your work that you do really, you know, comes to fruition and just really helps the community in the end.
Tell us about an issue that the Latino community is facing that you learned more about this summer.
I think I worked a lot with the education department of UCLA, and I think it's the Latino community as well as just the whole community in general, in that, you know, there's a depleting education process going on in California that many people are trying to fight against. And I think working with the Urban League and working on the side for education really gave me a new perspective on all the work people must put into, you know, getting their children educated, and how much pride people take in their communities and in their high schools that you really don't recognize as a student when you're in high school. But, I mean, after, it's a big problem that not many people know about.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How would you say that your leadership abilities developed over the summer?
I think I really became much more independent, because they gave me tasks where it was just, get this, and this done by any way possible. And I mean, they're always open to questions and everything, but they treated me like an employee. They gave me a task and said, okay, I want this done, you know, by Thursday afternoon before my meeting. So I would have to, you know, make some phone calls, look on the internet, search our own database, and just do different stuff on my own, and kind of, you know, have to gain that self-confidence to also be able to ask questions from different people and, you know, communicate with other workers. And it's just, I think it really just set me up for later on in my career.
Yeah, and on that note, do you think this internship better prepared you for your postgraduate plans?
Yeah, I think, wanting to get in business, it gives you a whole new perspective on just something that, you know, when you look at it, it's just community service or something when you're in high school, or when you're a young adult, it's just going out in the community. But I think working at the headquarters of the Urban League, it shows that, you know, the coordination and the communication needed between all different types of departments and, you know, different types of leadership skills. I got to speak with the CEO and the chief operating officer on different occasions, and it just shows they provide good mentorship and good figures to look up to. So I really think that it prepares you well for where you want to go, no matter what it is, because it's just the work life in general.
Why did you choose this specific internship?
I'm from Southern California, so it was close to home. And it was, I've always wanted to work in the community, and I think this was just perfect. I'd heard of the Urban League back at home before, so it was kind of cool to, you know, be on, you know, the receiving side of some of their benefits that they have, and then actually work on the side of, you know, delivering those benefits to other people. So it was really just passing on the help that I received when I was a kid. And I mean, it was just fun to help out others the way I was helped out as a child.
And describe a typical workday during your internship, as in getting up at, you know, 7, being to work by 8, coming home at 5. Did you stop anywhere along the way? What's a typical workday, and who do you interact with?
Usually, I wake up about 7:30 every day, get ready, shower, shave, take a nice little drive, slight traffic, not too bad in the morning, to where I get there at 9. I was usually actually the first person in my department to show up, because they usually gave me a task the day before that I had to do for the following day. So I'd show up, turn on the lights, you know, get some, they'd always have fruit or some type of snack there, and get something to eat, And then just start working. Other people would show up. I'd, you know, interact as they showed up. And then for usually in the morning, it was just I'd work on my task. Then we'd go to lunch. I'd go to lunch either with my boss, who was, you know, the chief of marketing, or other colleagues throughout the different department. And then after, when I would come back, it was usually there's more freedom. So she'd allow me to go. My boss would allow me to go into different departments, interact with different people, really try and get my, you know, footing in the company. And a lot of times I'd actually end up in the CEO's office and just chit-chatting for half an hour, 45 minutes, just whether it be about life or business or different plans, or if I had a question about the business. And that was real nice, because it gives you exposure to, you know, a vast amount of knowledge that they have, because, I mean, they were older than I was, and they're much more experienced business-wise. And then after that, I'd get out around 5, usually, try and beat traffic, take the streets home, find different ways, or sometimes, I mean, even just get out of work and head to Dodger Stadium, or head to downtown LA and eat at one of the restaurants or something like that. So it was all relatively close, so it wasn't really that bad.
And on that note, did you get to experience, it sounds like you are from LA, but I mean, someone that is not from LA, did you get a chance on the weekends to experience the area, go to the beach, do anything like Dodger Stadium?
Yeah, well, I myself went to a lot of places, but I lived there, so it was real easy for me. I guess the mystique is gone. It's kind of home. But I know others, the two other people in C-Clip, Patrick, they went to Six Flags, they went to Knott's Berry Farm, went to Disneyland, they went to the beach, they went to Dodger Stadium, and he actually got tickets to the ESPYs, and that was pretty cool. So that was an experience for them, and I remember talking to them the next day, because, I mean, they had two tickets, there's three of us. So you guys are here, go ahead and take it. Okay. And so, yeah, they really got the full experience of just being in LA. And
that's good. You know. Would you do this internship again, given the opportunity?
Yeah, I think really being able to work in the community and interact with people like you, or people actually completely different than you, is just an eye-opening experience, and teaches you that, I mean, you could always give more. And I think that's just, everyone should want to do that in life, just be able to give as much as possible. And I think working for a nonprofit or really being involved in the community just gives you a sense of pride that really can't be matched by some money or something like that. So, I mean, it's something that you really shouldn't pass up if you have the opportunity.
That's good. And what advice would you give future applicants to the internship?
I think know that you're going to work. It's not going to be all play. There's going to be work, and sometimes it's not going to be the best of work. It's going to be pretty tedious, but in the end, the experiences you gain are just amazing. Like, Pat got his tickets to the ESPYs from his work. And I mean, I got to go interact with different kids. And I know Michelle got to interact with different people throughout the community. So they make sure there's a real good work-life balance, to where it's a job, so you're going to work. But also, they're going to expose you to things that you'd never be exposed to in a different type of atmosphere, unless you're working for them or in an organization like that. So I think really, that just, you know, be open-minded and take it for what it's worth.
That's great. Thank you.